Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? So, I have been a very, very busy boy. I have, and if I just go to here, you can see it up there. I have ploughed and cultivated that section there and that section there. Now, you've seen me plough that in time-lapse. I did that after the episode finished, and then I cultivated all of it after the episode finished. We were cultivating this. I've gone round all of them with the roller as well. And I owe you an apology. I said at the beginning of the last episode that I would time-lapse all of the ploughing and the rolling. I did not time-lapse all of the ploughing, and only time-lapsed half of it, and I did not time-lapse any of the rolling. So it would appear that I am not a man of my word, which is something that fills me with great shame. I've missed a tiny little bit there with the roller, but I have gone all the way round, and as you can see, the shrubs do not disappear when you go over them with the roller, which is something of a disappointment, I must confess. I need to sow these fields next, and I'm thinking that I'm going to do beans right across the board. We're going to do two fields of beans here and fields of beans up top. However, we have no money, and we need to spread fertilizer first. Now, our fertilizer spinner was a leased machine. It wasn't a owned machine, so we got rid of it. So we have no fertilizer spinner. I don't want to plant the crops without fertilizer. I'd like to put fertilizer down first and then plant them. So we are going to go to the next stage, which you all wanted me to get land. Before we do that, at the moment, I have a mod available, which is from the mod hub. So there won't be a link for it. It's just one of the mods available on mod hub. The Juno 150. Now, this is a robotic cleaner, which will clean the feed areas in front of the animals. So my question for this week is, do you want me to just stay as we are using the Kramer and not use one of these? Would you like me to buy one of them and carry it between the two different animals that we've got, which you can do? I think you use the front loader for carrying it around. Or do you want me to buy two and station one here with the cows and one up by the pigs? It's your vote, it's your game. There should have been a little card come up here. Click on that to cast your vote, head into the comment section and let us know what you want. The other thing that I said for today was the comments section yesterday. The topic of discussion was, should I harvest and, you know, time-lapse me doing so, the potatoes in that field. It's now morning. I was cultivating and ploughing and so on last night, so it got late. I fast-forwarded time through to early morning now at just coming up to 7 o'clock, and the potatoes have been harvested. I was a little bit disappointed, to say the least, so I am unable to do that. So, yes, a lot of things that I told you I would do yesterday have not come to fruition. And I sincerely apologise. I really do. I hope you're not too disappointed with me. But what I am going to do to kind of make up for it is we want to get this field here. Now, we could plough up this little track up the side. If you look at the mini-map there, we don't actually need this track because it's just kind of a little shortcut one. So we've got a field there that we could do, and then we have a field of sugar beet right there that we could do. So to make up for my failings yesterday, I'm going to do both of these fields. Now, this one, Edward Gomez, we've only got a little bit, so we want to do some work for him. We have the 1660 axial flow. Let's see what others he offers us. Same. 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 And the TC5. That's an 18 foot. I think we'll go for this one. And as soon as I get started up and away, I'm going to time-lapse it. It's just going to be a little time-lapse. And then I will go over there and I will do that field and I will time-lapse that one for you as well. This is to make up for yesterday, because I promised you a lot of things yesterday, and I do feel bad because I didn't actually do any of them at all, actually, did I? I didn't time-lapse all. I did time-lapse some of the ploughing, but I wasn't able to do all of it. I literally just did not have enough time to do that. It was not possible for me to do it. However, that doesn't alter the fact that I told you I would, and then I failed to deliver. So, yeah. Let's get this bit time-lapsed, shall we? have almost finished. A tiny, tiny little bit left up through the middle here, and that one will be done. I'm going to get started on the sugar beet now. We'll take out the... How much did we get, first of all? 8,600 and 2,000, so we got 10,000, 11,000... nearly 11,300 euros. That's not too bad. That's not bad at all. So we're up to 10,000 euros, which means that we could... I mean, I think the next job on here would just be... a slurry job. Right, I'm going to worry about that one for a minute. We could now go and buy a... Oh, no, we don't want animals. We want fertilizer. Here we go. That one's 28,000, and that one's 6,000. I would prefer to get that one if I could, but I think, realistically, we are going to have to go for that one. I could get that and actually start doing the fertilizer, but first of all, I'm going to harvest this field, and I will do another time-lapse for this one. Before I time-lapse, we will just work over the end of the field. Dennis Jenkins, we've done a few jobs for him. I wonder what other field he's got. There is another one somewhere. So 40 minutes allowed for this one, and that is going to get us another 16,000 euros. We're going to use the Mac VRT. I'm not going to bother trying to go for it again. I can't imagine they would give us the massive, great big machine for it. I am, however, going to use the GPS mod on this one. But before I start the GPS mod, I'm going to do two passes along this lower headland, and then I will do two passes along the upper headland as well. The only bit that I don't like about this is the way it squashes the crop like that when you're trying to hitch in. I don't think that's particularly realistic, to be honest. It wouldn't completely destroy it, not just like that. It might render it so that you weren't able to... It might like damage the tops and that, but it wouldn't affect the sugar beet underneath. Because, I mean, we know that it wouldn't, because you drive over the sugar beets once you've run over them with a topper anyway. And it doesn't affect them, not like that. So we need to start that one up. Oh no, I think I've got to unfold it first, haven't I? No, apparently not. I just start it up. Right, he does lower into the ground. I'm going to raise him up out of the ground. And if I zoom out a little bit... It's not a very good time of day, to be honest. We haven't got the best light here. We'll work with what we got. This one, I start that one up. And then if I do Control V, it should lower both of them down. But at the same time, I'm going to want to be using the GPS mod. So I don't know how much Control V is going to affect the GPS. I don't know if that's a shortcut for anything on the GPS mod once we get started using that. I will find out once I get started, because I do want to be picking both the front and the back up when we turn on the headlands. I'm going to need to do at least two passes here. I think two is probably actually going to be enough. I don't think I need to do any more than that. So I come up to the end, then Control V again, and now I can turn. And you do have steering assist on the trailed sugar beet harvester. So the wheel does turn a bit as well, which it does help quite a lot. It really is quite surprising the assistance that thing gives. So now Control V to lower both of them down. Here it goes. And yes, I should really straighten up before I lower the back one down, but we can sort of just gloss over that bit and pretend that it didn't really happen. I just missed a little bit there. And as soon as you miss a bit, obviously, the wheels crush the crop, which isn't very good. Now, I've never done sugar beet in real life. There's always something that I wanted to get involved with. When I went to college, I did go on a trip to a sugar beet farm where they actually farmed sugar beet for... That was one of the main crops of the farm that they ran sugar beet on that place. And it was quite fascinating. They would lift them all through the winter, and they had these massive great big storage areas where they could store the sugar beet. So they would go out when it wasn't hoofing it down with rain and harvest it. But they had a bit of a challenge, because some places they only harvest the sugar beet when it's ready to come out of the ground. Or not when it's ready to come out of the ground. They only harvest it when it's ready to, when the factory wants it. And then other places, because it's so wet and so the soil is so claggy, so wet and just grips to the machines, they can't really do it like that. So what they have to do is they lift a lot of it early, and then they store it in cold storage. So it's kind of similar to being stored in the ground. And it stays, it's got to stay cool. If it goes above a certain temperature, it damages the sugars and they don't convert properly, or something. I'm not quite, I can't remember exactly how it was, but I do remember seeing the field where it had been harvested. He had a tractor mounted harvester, much the same as this one actually. It wasn't all that dissimilar from this one. And then he also had, there was this huge storage area, and the storage area, that was impressive. That was really, really, that was sort of the most impressive part of the trip, was seeing the storage area. He had these massive, great big sheds, huge. And the sugar beet was in there, it was cleaned and boxed. And it was all cold storage. He had these huge, great big refrigeration units on it. It's not the sort of thing you would normally expect to see on a farm. I've got to be honest, I did not expect to see that kind of thing on a farm. So now I'm just going to turn the GPS mod on. And we go here. Now, I want to set the work... See, that's not the working width. Because I've got this trail thing on the back, it's not setting the correct working width at the moment. I've got to straighten up and make sure that I've got this lined up properly. And then it will allow me. Well, it should do anyway. I'm hoping it will. Let's try that and see what that does. Auto. Right, that's a bit better. That's looking a bit more promising. I'm just going to leave it there. I'll leave the lines up for this one so that we can sort of see what it's doing. I'll have the auto turn. And I'm going to assume that we're going to need to skip at least one. So if I have skipping one lane, auto turn, I think that's everything. So let's do that. And I'll leave the interface up for a moment. And I will close it down in a minute. As long as this is actually working properly, I'll close the interface down and we will carry on and harvest. I'm going to try and harvest like this so that we can look at it. And I will remove the map. There we go. We get down to the end and we'll just see that he turns okay. I want to see how many lanes he takes to do a full turn, so that I can sort of see what it's going to be like, and then I will start time-lapsing it. So we've got the I've got a second time-lapse in this episode for you to make up for my massive failures yesterday. I wasn't happy about that. I really wasn't. So come up to there, and I've just got enough room to be able to turn, but I don't know what it's going to be like when he's put it down again. Yeah. This is going to make it more difficult. Because I've got to do it like this, I'm going to sort of miss piece. I think I should maybe take another slice at the end. Look at that. I'm missing a great big chunk there, which isn't very good. Yeah. That's as far out as I can go. I think maybe I really should take another slice at the end. I'll tell you what. I'm just going to keep going like this, and I will time-lapse this for you. So let's just remove that. I'll keep the lines on there so you can sort of have a bit of a view of what's happening. And zoom in a little bit so you get a good view of it. There, I think that's a good angle to watch it. That might actually be it before we get to the end of this row. Well, maybe not. Might just have to start on the next one. It's not done too bad, I don't think, using the GPS. We've got some neat, tidy rows. It seems to have kept with the width fairly well. I was quite pleased with how it did. I have had to spend quite a bit of time correcting it because it's wanting to drift quite a long way at the end of each row. And it keeps wanting to turn the wrong way, that sort of thing, because we didn't get it quite right at the start. It's not been great, but yeah, you know, overall I've been reasonably impressed with it. Right, just come forward. Now I want to bring that one round and then lower them both down. Hopefully, because I've been pressing control while the GPS mod is open in order to lower both of them. If you press the left control button and V, it lowers both the front and back implements at the same time. And I'm hoping it hasn't made it too glitchy. Obviously, I'm not going to know this until after it's all edited and rendered, by which time there won't be a lot I can do about it. I think this is going to be it any second now. Go on. 9 minutes to go. No. It does take it. You get it. Oh, there we go. Right. And we've got a fraction under, so that's 80, a fraction under 19,000 euros. So that's put us up to 29,000 euros. And we've got both of these fields. They would both have now missions for slurry, and then they would both have missions for ploughing. I might not do a couple of those missions before next episode. Really, it depends on how much time I've got. I don't think I'm going to be able to. We will possibly have a look at some of it in our next episode. I'm not really sure yet. But what we do need to do now is we're going to go and get a fertilizer spreader because we have enough money for it. We want to get some fertilizer spread onto the cultivated fields. And then once we've spread fertilizer on the fields, we can then get going with the seed drill. And I'm going to plant beans. I'm going to plant beans across the board. That's not the first. Well, we'll get the fertilizer and we can do the fertilizer spreading. Then we can set the seed drill going. I don't think we're going to get as far as getting a seed drill on its way today. But once we get it just moving up and down the field a bit, and we've done a bit on the headlands, we are going to need to do something to the animals. Because if you take a look, I will just show you a second. Here we go. Right. Those two are now harvested, and I don't know if they've been ploughed. No, they haven't. So there will be ploughing missions on those next. That up there is not been fertilised. It's on one stage up there. Those would have fertiliser missions, I suppose. Anyway, that's not the bit that I'm looking at. I'm getting distracted again. We have 0% cleanliness on all of it, and most of the food and water and everything else is just about out on both the pigs and the cows. We are up to 17 pigs now. We're not doing too bad at all with the pigs. They are on 85% productivity. We need potatoes or sugar beet in order to feed them. So we will, at some point, plant those. But we need to wait until we can get the machinery in order to do the harvest. But our pig numbers are climbing. We're not going to be selling any of those for quite a while yet. We've got a nice lot of liquid manure and manure as well from the cows. And we're going to need to get some power food. So next episode, the first thing that we're going to be doing is concentrating on feeding the cattle and the pigs. We're going to get some of the silage that's in that bunker into the cattle. We're going to take a whole load of corn over to the pigs. We've got two trailers now that we can load up and take them over. So it will just be two trips to the pigs and then back again. I think we've got everything that we need for feeding them in our silos, because we need corn as the base feed. And then we need either beans, canola or sunflowers as the protein feed. We need a base grain as wheat or barley, and I believe we've got all of them. Actually, let's just take a quick look. Right, we've got those two, we've got some canola left over, and we've got loads of corn, so we should be okay for that. We should be, so we're not going to need to worry about getting any more. We might, after we've harvested beans, if we're going to plant beans next, we might just have to keep a few ton of beans back and then sell all the rest, so that we've got enough protein feed to go in for the pigs. We've got loads of corn. The wheat and the barley, we'll keep hold of that for now. And if we get enough money, what I'd like to do is to get some, buy some more pigs. But as this is the animal one, we also need to get some sheep. That is something else that we're going to need to do. Right, let's go to fertilizer spreaders. We're going to go for the cheap one. So let's buy that one. There we go. 6,300 euros. That leaves us with 23,000, which isn't too bad. We're going to use a bit of that to fill the fertilizer spreader, obviously. I don't know if there's anywhere else that we can fill the fertilizer spinner. You always used to be able to do it at the garden centres and places like that. At the moment, we've got a fill point back at the farm, but I don't know if we got anywhere else on the map. Let's just take a look. Oop, was a fraction too far. So we can fill here, lumber yard, village grain elevator. You've got a fill station there. You've got the bakery and the animal point there. Biogas transport spinnery, garden centre down here. I don't think that there is any fill point, although it doesn't actually say on the map if there's a fill point. Mind you, it's a long way to go. It doesn't seem to be any closer. Yeah, I don't think it's going to be beneficial to try and do that. Okay, let's take this fertiliser spinner back to the main yard and we'll get that first field going with fertiliser. We may even be able to start planting our beans. And yes, we're definitely going to do beans right across the board. That'll get us a good cash crop. I think I'm doing beans on another one of the maps. I might have even done beans on two of the other maps. Beans are good. Beans make a lot of money. And I don't really want to do sunflowers yet because the corn header that we've got, it does it at regular speed and it's quite slow. Whereas if we could get an actual sunflower header, that cuts it at, I think it's half as much again. I think your standard speed is 6 miles an hour, whatever that is. I think that's about 10 kilometers. About 10 kilometers an hour. And then the sunflower header does it at 9 miles an hour, which is roughly 15 kilometers an hour, I think. I think that's the conversion rate. I'm not quite sure. I don't normally work in kilometers. Here in the UK, we are mostly metric, but we are a bit unusual in that we still do all of our measurements, distance measurements in miles. Just to make things a little bit confusing for everybody involved. And if I just come up here, I think, actually, if we back underneath there, I think that's where we can get some fertilizer. It should just drop down into our spinner. There we go, refill. So how much does it cost to refill the spinner? The other thing that we're going to need to do, right, that's stopped, is it? Oh, there we go, 1,259 euros. So cheap at half the price. Not quite. The other thing we need to do is that other Zeta, because this one, you don't have the option for it. So we're going to have to get the other Zeta, and we're going to need to put the care wheels, the row crop tires, on it, so that we can do the fertilizer spreading for the other two passes that we're going to need to do before we finish. I think this is far enough over. Yeah, that's more than enough. I will just move out a little bit. And we'll set the hired help doing this once we've gone round once. Actually, we don't even need to go round once. We only need to do a pass up this end and a pass down the other end. I've actually gone, a fraction too far out now. I'll just move drift back slightly so that I just pick up the very end of it. There we go. And turn that one off. And now if I go speeding down to the other end and we do one pass there. Now, obviously, you've got to be careful up against the water. We don't want to be throwing fertilizer into the water. That is very, very bad. And I was talking about slurry runoff in the Goldcrest Valley episode, and someone has told me some very interesting information all about the slurry runoff, what it's called and everything else. And I was going to talk about that, but then I thought, well, no, that was actually to do with the Goldcrest. And I know that some people only watch one particular series. You know, some of you only watch Sosnovka and some of you only watch Goldcrest. So I will wait until Monday's Goldcrest episode before I mention him and the information that he told me, because I find it quite fascinating. I thought it was absolutely fascinating, the stuff that he told me, and so I'm hoping that some of you will find it very, very interesting as well. I'll just come back over here. We can set the hired help going now. If I go whizzing along here, you can see it's squared up quite nicely with the roller, and I did the rolling. Did I do the rolling at night? I think I did. I think I did the rolling at night and then I went through. So there is definitely no grass growth here at all. The grass is gone. That's never coming back. And now I will set the hired help going. And I'm not using the GPS mod. Some people say and have said to me, now that you've got the GPS mod, you never need to use hired help. I like using hired help because you can walk away and you can leave it. I know it costs money to run the hired help. I know that they are a little bit expensive. However, the alternative is to sit and watch every single bit of it, or do it myself. And I don't really want to do either of those. And I don't really think that a small tractor like that... Yes, you could have the GPS system in it, but I don't really think it is all that realistic to sort of portray having a GPS system on a tractor like that. You wouldn't... I don't think you would normally. It would be more of a rarity to have GPS running on a machine like that. So we're going to just wash this tractor a second. And I have also been asked if I could very kindly do this with a little bit more realism. I'm far too lazy when it comes to washing my machinery. I tend to just take the machine and point it at one area, and then magically the whole machine gets clean. So I will actually wash my tractor properly. So there's the weight. And then we need to wash the tractor on both sides, not just one side. And if there's anything else that I do that just irritates you a little bit, then just mention it in the comments section. I haven't actually given a topic of discussion for today, have I? I don't think I've... I know what I want to discuss today. There is a mod that I am seriously considering buying. I'd like to get another tractor, and at the moment, I know that I asked you the question for these four tractors, and that is the one there that everybody wants me to get. I don't have 172,000 euros at the moment, so I'd like to get something as a bit of a stopgap, something to keep us going with power. And this bad boy is back in town. That one right there, the Kirovets 700A, the old Russian favourite. This is a beast of a tractor. It's 220 horsepower. It's going to cost us 420 a day in maintenance, but it's only 78,000 euros. Now, 220 horsepower. We got nothing that compares to that. 145, 166, 220. It's the same as these. It's the same power as these tractors here, right? 210 up to 225. These are 100. These are over 100,000 more than this one. So, topic of discussion for today in the comment section: what do you think of me getting the Kirovets tractor as a kind of stopgap until we get enough money to buy our big tractor? What do people think of me doing that? Would you be pleased for me to get that Russian favourite again? I have used it a few times in the past, and it probably won't be the last time that I use it. Right, hang on, I've just got the back of the tractor to do. It's always a bit fiddly just in here. This is always where the worst of the mud accumulates, and you would think that a lot of the mud would accumulate here. That particular hitch right there, I've never driven a tractor that has actually got that hitch. I think that's more of a continental thing. The only hitch I've ever had on a tractor is down there, and I've driven a lot. That isn't something you would normally see in the UK. At least it wasn't when I was regularly driving machines. But no, the mud would normally accumulate here. It gets up onto the wheels, and then it sort of accumulates on top of the bar, on top of the axle bar right there, on both sides. And that's where the worst of the mud will get. And also, you've got to get up in under the mud guards in behind, and that's terrible because that splashes right back at you, and it's absolutely awful. It sprays you with mud. It doesn't matter what angle you get. When you're cleaning your tractor properly and you're getting up in under the mudguards there, you get absolutely plastered in filth, but at least you have a clean tractor. Right, I have run out of time, unfortunately, so we will have to start our seed drilling next time. My question for this week, the Lely Juno 150, is a robot cleaner. It will clean the feed area of the animals. So do you want me to just stick with the Kramer that we've been using, the front loader Kramer, and use that one to continue cleaning the feeding area and not buy one of these? Would you like me to buy one of these and move it between the two animal feeding areas? We would use the Kramer to pick it up and carry it around. I think that's how it's carried. It can also drive itself, I think, but it's very, very slow. Or would you like me to buy two of them and put one at the cattle and one over at the pigs? It's your vote. It's your game. Mouse over in the top corner up here and cast your vote on the card. Let us know in the comments section and see if you can't persuade others to vote the way that... Ooh, excuse me, I've got the hiccups now. To vote the way that you're voting. Now, I'm going to get the seed drill hitched on, ready, and we can do that next episode. We've got animals to feed in our next episode. We got lots and lots to do. The fertilizer is almost finished. I think he's got two more passes of the field there. So let me just back up to here. If you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give me a like. Oops, I did not mean to do that. Let's try getting this on straight, shall we? And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. But until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.